Whew. Wow. So I just come from the test drive. I have a live wire here today. And here it is. Brother, take the camera off this thing. So first impressions. Extremely fun. And actually, I just want to say, Harley, you should be proud of this. Why rebrand it? It is a fantastic bike. There's a Buddhist monk here. You might have to ask him two things. Hello there.
Hi.
Have you seen the quiet one?
It's so good.
This is electric.
Sorry.
Okay. I thought you were filming. This is a electric Harley.
Sorry, English is not good.
Okay.
I'm being so cool.
Okay, nice to meet you. Well, that was fun. We met a Zen Buddhist here. But yeah, today basically is a test drive to just get the experience going and then answer the question, you know, what's the right bike, what's the future? But looking at Harley, I'm like, why would you hide this? This is really the future. This is where everything's going. So I'm not understanding why they rebranded and not proudly go with this as the future. For some reason, and there's a wonderful book in the store that is all the classic history of the history of Harley Davidson, its fashion, its innovation, its amazing, beautiful old-fashioned bikes and technology and the way they put everything together. And then they had these beautiful coats and glasses and graphics on it. If you look at that classic book, I gotta pull it up, some pictures. That was Harley in the last century, driven by cutting-edge innovation, and then somehow the success got them, and now they're all making these massive, let's say, what is it, 1200 liter engines. And in this weather, you don't want to be sitting on one of those in Washington State, because you cannot go anywhere, you're sitting in traffic. And with this thing, it's cool, it feels, this is the future. So Harley, embrace it. Your electric bike also looks awful. I mean, you should completely redesign that from the principles of a few brand experience principles of what is Harley all about. This looks like it's done in that way, can even be done better. And then with a new generation, this is absolutely the future. I cannot help but smile. I was just smiling for an hour in traffic on this thing. You're just jubilant. You have an infinite amount of power in your wrist. It's simple. There's, yeah, I cannot say ions is the way, whatever lithium ion is the way. And all you want is a little bit lighter, although it still feels pretty agile, I must say. You want it to be a little bit lighter. You want it to be at least 50 kilos lighter and longer range, which is a challenge, of course, but still it's agile. With this, it's day trips. You want to do a 300 mile tour. You got to do quick charge somewhere, maybe do over lunch. So if the network is there, it's not a problem. For the rest, you're there, you know. The $22,000, so it's $8,000 cheaper currently, but with tax you still end up closer to the 30. But you can drive with this for the rest of your life, because all you need to buy is new tires and some other components. So I would say yes. I am having the biggest smile on my face when you're in this thing on the road, when you open it up. You feel absolutely superior, because if you put it on, and I haven't even tried the crazy mode yet. I've only done it on road mode, because I didn't like the regenerative braking. I don't want it to continuously, you know, as soon as you idle, that it goes into braking. You want to coast. So I haven't tried that even yet. But even in the road mode, just going from anywhere on the highway, whatever speed you're doing, you, as soon as you hit that accelerator, everything stands still. cars, even driving cars, are standing still. So you can basically drive around as if all cars are parked. And yes, you're going fast, but the whole landing gear of this thing, it's just solid. So you feel in charge. Braking feels great. It's also, I think it's a fly-by-wire throttle. Braking is hydraulic, but there's a balancing system in there. So you just feel in control, you feel safe, it's heavy, it has that centrifugal force that will ride you, get you over obstacles. In that sense, geometry-wise, it's a weird little wobble in there somewhere, a collie wobble, when you do hit the steering wheel a little bit. Cornering was good, I haven't pushed it at all, obviously. You're up to 80, 90 miles an hour in no time. Not going to post it on the video because obviously that would be immediately illegal. I hope I don't get a ticket. And what's this weird thing actually? There's this giant ugly ass fender. I mean, there's a lot of design stuff that can be done, but it's also very long, so it seems extremely long wheelbase, which might be good for the anti-wheelie. Yeah, I mean, design review, I can go into deeper. I just feel as you're driving it, there's a lot of cheap stuff on here. Like this, again, the screen is nice, but it also looks a little bit like an Android tablet of the 80s or whatever. This, I mean, look here, you got hydraulics again, which is great. Maybe that should also be fly-by-wire, or that costs too much energy, too much electricity, so you want to rely on that. It's only one tube here, then you've got the rear brake is obviously also hydraulic, yes, with the whole system there. Now anyway, I'm maybe going on too long, but I would say a big huge smile on the bike experience, and can't say it's not impressive with a couple of double Brembos on the front. I ran into a Zen Buddhist and he agreed with me, as you can see in the next bit, but I'll leave it uncut so you can hopefully hear me as I fly around with a big smile on my face. So Harley, embrace this. This is your future. This is what you should be doing. Those old Harley riders won't be around anymore in a few years. And as far as family values, the next generation needs to embrace this future. You should not. It's literally like owning a horse, right? That's what Elon Musk said about internal combustion engines. In a couple of years, it's like a hobby, like having a horse. So I would say embrace it as a brand. Reinvent yourself with that future forward fashion that you have in there. You just need the right team to be able to harness it, and the right CEO to believe in. Go for it. I'm out. Okay, let's go on eco mode for now. No itchy boots, but today's video. Just don't hope I lose my... Okay, so switch it on. Switch it on. Feels interesting, yeah? And we got start up. Press start for a few seconds. On real life. Okay. See how it feels. Here we go. Quiet and lead. Let's just do a couple of laps here first. That is eco mode. Oh, just blow everybody away. Obviously that's highly legal, but kind of fun. Huh? Let's pretend I'm going straight. And then, now this is risky. I'm going to just squeeze past here. And then you're on front, which is not allowed at all. One, because this is a so attractive corner that you risk killing yourself. We don't want to do that. Investigate. Hey, these stinky cars are really smelly. So don't kill yourself in this corner. Let's do do it gently on the throttle. And we don't have ridiculous, we only have road mode. How about some road mode? Let's see. Let's just take it easy. Wow. Nice move. Is it still on? Yeah, it is. It's the problem. Sometimes you know, oh, please, no, don't go, no. Don't do it, 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 don't do it. And there we go. Hang on that thing. The nice thing is you don't have the heat.
Really?
Yeah, it's cold.
Can I ask you something personal?
Sure.
How much?
I think currently they're 23 grand.
Woo! What year?
Oh, this is brand new. I just took it from the dealer. I'm testing it.
What year? Oh, it's brand new.
22.
Wow.
So it's not too bad.
It's pretty, man.
If you compare it to a Harley, which it basically is, it's a lot cheaper.
I bet it's a whole lot faster.
Oh my goodness, it's insane. It literally is insane. It's like you're going through a time warp.
Wow.
It's pretty cool, I must say. I really love it.
How many gears?
It's all automatic, zero.
No way.
Look, I got nothing here. No clutch. No, how do you call it? Zero. I just go like this, like a go-kart.
Man, are you serious?
Insane. And then you have the brake that's connected, so they balance automatically.
Are you gonna buy it?
I got a petrol engine motorbike. It's fairly new, but I'm considering if it's a lot of money, right?
Yeah, but it looks like it's automatic.
It's totally automatic. Do you ride bikes?
Yeah.
You do? What do you have?
Huh?
What do you have?
I ride, but I don't have one. I don't own one right now.
Gotcha.
But I've ridden a lot of them.
Oh, you did? Yeah.
But I can't imagine riding an electric.
It feels really good. If you go to Harley Bellevue, you can take one out for a spin if you want, for free.
Really?
I'm just doing an hour test ride for free.
Wow.
Let me know when I need to get ready. And the good news is no earplugs.
Really?
Ah.
Rachel, hold up, Rachel.
Couple more coming.
I would buy it if I was you. That looked like a pretty good toy, man.
A toy for sure, yeah. But the only thing is you can't do large tours right through the, you know, you can't do the cascade loop or anything like that.
You're gonna get a lot of tickets, man.
Did you? Well, I hope I didn't get one just now. You open it up and it's... Ah, follow me, huh?
All right, boss. Enjoy your bike, man.
Thank you, sir. Have a good day.
You too, man.
Go ride one.
Oh, all right.
Ooh, there's the pilot color. Follow me. Safety car. I think it's live. Livewire, Harley, let's go. You can also try some agility stuff here on the car for us, right? I don't think I have a petrol. Really, you can do slow agility stuff, right? Locking the wheels and stuff like that. Trail braking. Okay. Yeah, it's heavy. There we go. Find us, find us.